Ross Colton joining us live, fresh off of that victory. I thought maybe you would be doing this interview, Ross, from like a beach or, you know, poolside, but I don't know what the rules are when you're trying to win your, you know, another Stanley Cup in Tampa.
Yeah, I should have went out on the balcony. I'm looking out at the ocean right now, but it's a little bit too hot out there. I need to relax and stay in the shade, I think.
Well, listen, we appreciate you stepping out of the sun to come on our show because we know it is much nicer outside than in your hotel room. I'll ask you this. This time of year is so busy. You guys are playing every other night. What do you do on a quote-unquote off day to get ready for the next game? I assume it's different for every player.
Yeah, you know, a lot of guys kind of try to stick to a routine and whatnot. But for me, I kind of just like to, you know, hang out with the guys, maybe, you know, sit on my phone and maybe take a nap or whatnot. But, you know, for the most part, I kind of, just like I said before, stay out of the hot Florida sun. I shouldn't be out by the pool. I think if I showed up to the rink with a tan, Coop would be a little annoyed with me. So definitely not trying to get sunburned.
Hey, Ross, I want to ask you about just the way the playoffs have gone so far. You guys have managed games, found ways to win. It hasn't always been puppies and roses in the first round, and even the way the game started yesterday. But you mentioned Coop, and I feel like he's just so calm and cool, right? Like, says the right things, gets you guys thinking the right way, and you guys have managed it really well. What's been kind of the mantra so far in the playoffs with your team?
Yeah, I think, you know, for the most part, I think we've kind of just tried to stick to the mindset of, you know, we're never out of the fight. You know, I've heard that phrase a couple of times here. And, you know, I just think for us, like you said, we might not score five goals. I think if we just play the right way, you know, the goals will happen. And, you know, we saw that last night. I think we kind of knew they were going to come out strong. We weathered the storm there for the first period and a half, kind of settled in and then played our game. And then the, you know, goals start to come. But, you know, credit to the guys. I thought we bought into, you know, blocking shots and playing good in the D zone. And then, you know, the goals happened, you know, later in the game.
So Ross, as you guys know, as I always point out, he's from New Jersey. So, you know, I'm always pulling for the Jersey guys.
Yes, you are.
I wasn't really digging that play in front of the net there when Sherratt gave you a little bit of a, it was a headbutt. It wasn't
like a tap.
It wasn't too bad. But I mean, I got some friends in Jersey that can look into this. Why? I mean, like, you know, we don't dig that. I mean, what was going on here?
Yeah, I don't know. I think there was just some pushing and shoving in front of the net, and then maybe he was trying to whisper something out of me in my ear. I don't know, but in the heat of the moment, I don't really know that it happened. And then I saw it afterwards, but you know, it's just, you know, two guys battling in front of the net.
Well, I'll say this: you were unfazed.
Yeah,
by
he
it,
was,
which is impressive.
Which
I think
is what
most
you want.
People in that spot might lose their cool, but you didn't seem bothered at all. I want to ask you about something Steven Stamkos said after the Game 7 victory against the Maple Leafs. You know, they asked him about some of the deadline acquisitions, and he said, "You know, we always talk. You know, people always talk about the Bolts and how we acquire great players, and they have such an impact on the ice." He said, "But what people don't realize is the character of the people that we bring into our team, and everybody on this team has a certain character and a certain quality to who they are as people. What can you tell us just about the character of the Tampa Bay Lightning as a team and the type of people that fit into that dressing room?"
Yeah, I think, you know, that goes a long way. I think we definitely try and, you know, bring guys who are good people on and off the ice. You know, you've seen that with, you know, guys in the past with Blake Coleman and Barkley Goodrow. They did, you know, so much for our team, and, you know, David Savard, you can go down the list. And then this year they brought in definitely some characters, and Nick Paul and Brandon Hagel. They came in from day one and, you know, like to, you know, run their mouths in the locker room and definitely have big personalities. And, you know, I think it kind of changed the way our team goes about, because, you know, there's a lot of quiet guys, and, you know, these guys are coming in chirping and, you know, teasing guys all day. So it definitely lightens the mood a little bit, but, you know, you could see both of them, they flick a switch when, you know, the time comes and they're ready to go.
You say big personalities and then you mentioned chirps. Do the chirps just fly in that room or what?
No, I think it's all fun and games. But like I said, they like to, you know, lighten the mood. And, you know, they're always going back with Alex Killorn and Pat Maroon and those guys. So if you could be a fly on the wall, I think you would get a good laugh with what was going on in the room.
I have no doubt.
Yeah, you talk about lightening the mood. At least on our side of it, as far as on Twitter and watching the game, the world exploded when Cooch came in and just gave the old whoop whoop in inside and outside.
Yeah.
What was the reaction on the bench? Like, have you guys just seen this so much from this guy, or is he still amaze you?
I think it's a little bit of both. He definitely, you know, amazes us still, you know, every day, but we see it so many times in practice that it's kind of, it's honestly just another day at the office for him. But, you know, on the bench last night, guys were definitely looking at each other like, oh my God, did, you know, that actually just happened, especially against, you know, such a good D-man in Ekblad. So, you know, if he could keep doing that and keep gift wrapping it for guys, I think we're going to have a lot of success here.
Let me ask you, let me go back to that first round series against the Leafs, because it was a real back and forth. I mean, they really gave it to you in game one. You guys keep finding ways to bounce back. And then in game seven, it was a tight, tense game. I thought you guys were able to control the tempo enough that you end up getting the win. What was that like? You've been in a couple of game sevens. Now you were in one against the Islanders last year. This one on the road, I would say it looked like it was right down to the end. What was the feel like in the room and for you in that game?
Yeah, there was definitely a lot of nerves. You know, like I said, like you said, the Islanders game seven, that was another, you know, tight match. And we kind of knew that going into the game, it wasn't going to be like the, you know, previous six and, you know, being like a 5-4 game. We knew that both teams were going to play defensive game and, you know, be physical and kind of just try and play the right way. So we knew it was going to go the distance. Luckily, we bought into the system of, you know, the amount of guys that, you know, put their body on the lines and block shots in that third period was awesome. And it was definitely contagious. You saw that, you know, down to the last whistle. And, you know, I thought Vazzy, you know, again, just him and, you know, clinching games is, you know, something else. And he was a brick wall for us.
All right, we got a Leafs girl here. So you want to say
God.
You want to say a few nice things about the Leafs. I mean, they gave it their all. They gave it their all.
No, I mean, they have such a bright future. They really do. I mean, the amount of credit you give to those guys, they have, you know, so much talent, and obviously it could have went either way, you know, game seven, 2-1 game. It was a great series, and you know, they definitely have a bright future.
Well, now viewers of the show can't get mad at me for being
there, you go,
biased, right? I can't be a homer anymore. I'm totally objective now, so viewers at home will be happy about it.
I know. I think you're well documented here.
Yeah, listen, I am who I am.
That's
always
right.
Have been. But
that's right.
You know, before we let you go, Ross, obviously you're only one game into this series against the Florida Panthers. They've had a heck of a season. What do you expect in game two, and how can you guys, what can you guys do, or how do you guys need to play to come out of this thing with a 2-0 series lead on the road? I guess it's the road.
Yeah, the road, just a 30-minute flight, right? it's pretty nice, but no, I think that we know that they're going to come out strong. They're going to have a, you know, hard push. I think you know, they definitely probably didn't like the way that they played there in that first game and the outcome, obviously. So we can't get too you know, too high on that win. We kind of just got to turn the page, and you know, I thought we did a good job with that, you know, today in practice, and kind of just you know, take it into this next one with the right mindset of kind of the same thing, weather that storm, and then kind of once the game settles in, you know, start playing our game again.
All right. Well, 4 goals in the postseason for you so far.
Yeah.
Congrats on that. Best of luck the rest of the way. And I got to say, if I see Coop on the bench tomorrow and he has a tan, that's just not fair. If you're not allowed to have a tan, he's not allowed to have a tan.
No. Good point.
Yeah, no, maybe I'll go catch some Rays here before the team dinner.
Yeah, I think you scored last night. I think you're allowed. Thank you for this, and we appreciate the time.